At New AFC promised more jobs and a good life. Instead, we lost 30,000 jobs. Taxes went up, people are less safe, and cost of living skyrocketed. Now, after 4 years of neglect and corruption, the APNU AFC gang are coming with more empty promises, only cause they need you now. We are smart. Fool me once, shame on you. This time, we will not be fooled by your sneaky fake news, APNU promises. We vote in PPPC to get Guyana working again.
Good evening and welcome to Square Talk, and I am happy Eid to all Guyanese, especially our Muslim brothers and sisters, and I hope you spent it the way you had desired most. This evening's program will focus on happenings in Guyana. We're coming live via the NTN Radio Television Facebook, as well as Freedom Radio 91.1 FM and its Facebook, and also we're coming live via the People's Progressive Party Civic Facebook. And so this evening I will be bringing you highlights on a number of issues, more particularly surrounding our outstanding elections, as it ought to have taken place a long time now. Of course, we are in a country in which we continue to observe and witness a president in the person of David Granger, who is spearheading at this time a caretaker government, and who continue to demonstrate his dishonesty, and of course how untrustworthy and unreliable he is. And of course, this is a person that is heading our nation that is without integrity. The president holds no integrity. There's some people who like to make claim to Granger being a decent and honorable man. But no one can be decent and honorable and behave in the way and manner we continue to observe and witness with this specific individual. No president can be honorable and decent and behave in this manner. You can not be decent and honorable when you continue to violate the Constitution of Guyana. You have violated it in the past and you continue to do so. You cannot be honorable and decent when you refuse to tell the nation the truth about what is taking place, because you are giving excuses after excuses. You are delaying the elections and the inevitable of APNU AFC losing government. You're delaying that all because you want to buy time. And the buying time is not for the sake of doing it only. It is purposefully to continue to steal from our treasury. And why do you think the government and the president is so hell-bent on not having the cabinet resign? Let me tell you, the cabinet is like the heart of the government in terms of its the administrative, well, basically in terms of what it does to create the functioning in the society with contracts and other important business and work of the government. And there must have been good reason why the framers of the Constitution decided that on the fall, the defeat of a government by a no confidence motion, that the cabinet resigns immediately. The cabinet resigns so that that aspect of government no longer functions. So it means that you can no longer transact and conduct business in involving large sums of money and involving the resources of the state in a big way. So the Constitution provided for the resignation of the cabinet. And so while the cabinet resigns, the government, which is the elected body, the government will then continue to function as a body, but in a routine fashion and in a routine manner to facilitate only the elections and the elections only. And that is what the intention is. This whole game and gimmick by the president and his cabal about not having the cabinet resign because of their CCJ not giving any coercive orders in terms of saying that the cabinet must resign. But there again goes the dishonesty of David Granger and his cabal when they say that the CCJ did not intend to have the cabinet resign. First of all, the Constitution specifies it and outlines it very, very, very clearly. Very clearly. And secondly, in the CCJ's decision, they did lament the fact that the cabinet ought to have resigned and it must resign. And so here it is, you have a group of people who are so dishonest that they try to change the words of the CCJ and they try to tell us that it meant something other than what it is intended to mean and what their action should be. And so this is why, and David Granger is at the helm of all of this dishonesty, of all of this dishonesty. And we are where we are today. In meeting people in the streets and at the office and elsewhere, like many others, are encountering conversations like, when do we have elections? What is going on? I'm tired, I'm frustrated, I'm disgusted by this situation. But who has caused all of this? Who has caused all of this? The Constitution provides for a no confidence motion. So the opposition having brought a no confidence motion, you can call it the norm of our democracy. So you can call it a part of our democratic game, so to speak. So that is not the reason for calling the situation or making the situation what it is today, because the Constitution provides for that, and all the players should expect at any one point in time you could have a no confidence motion against the government. But then you have a government that refused to adhere to the provisions of the Constitution that says the cabinet should resign, first of all, and that they should be preparing for elections within 3 months of falling as a government. And that happened first. The motion was passed on December 21st, 2018, and the 3 months deadline for the elections was March 21st, 2019. And there we saw David Granger and all his representatives and government ministers and such like dancing around the place, all sorts of trickery, techniques, maneuverings to avoid going to elections. When they admitted in the first place since the passage of the motion on the night of the 21st of December that they recognized that the government had fallen and that they had to prepare for elections, they changed the tune and then they all around the place running around like headless chicken and cornered rats. So that is the situation. They refused to adhere to the Constitution. They engaged the courts. The courts pronounced they refused to adhere to the court decision, the final court of Guyana, the CCJ. And so they are the ones who have our country in the kind of uproar we experience today, where business continues to slide downward, where people are frustrated and fed up and disgusted by what is taking place in the society. People's lives at this time is so tentative because they are awaiting the elections, and the president will not call the date for the elections, though he would have us like us to believe that this date has to come from GCOM. Nonsense. Absolute nonsense coming from this caretaker president, the most dishonest and dishonorable individual we have at the helm of our country. This is sheer crookery in the person and in the name of David Granger. The date for the elections must be called by the president, must be named by the president. Not because Kwame Mc Coy is saying that, but because the Constitution provides for that. The Constitution states it very clearly that the president should be the one naming the elections date. Then GCOM, as a constitutional body, will then comply and adhere to that date and get ready for that date. It is not the opposite way and in the opposite direction as David Granger would like us to believe. There again, how dishonest and deceptive that this president is, all the time making excuses, dancing around the issues, flip-flopping, providing excuses that are nonsensical, and he is just about deceiving this nation, creating tensions in our society and the divisions that we see every day as a result of his action and non-action. We have a duty, citizens of this country, to increase and intensify the pressure on this government. And I dare say tonight that we must ensure, all of us, that we stand on the side of the Constitution. And what does that mean? This is beyond, far and above, any political party or any partisan interest. Our Constitution is our supreme law. And we, at all times, despite wherever we are, wherever, whichever side we stand, whichever organization we have an association with, or group, or individual, we must all be able to draw the line when it comes to our Constitution being breached and in violation, as it is so clearly experiencing by the president and his government. We now need to ensure that every single day this president, and from now, we need to intensify the pressure, because the elections must be held by the constitutional date as prescribed by the Constitution, the 3 month, with June 18 as the ruling coming from the CCJ, which means the 3 months end in September 18, 2019. And we have a duty, all of us as Guyanese, to stand up. And I'm saying to all of us that we don't really, in this country, we don't appreciate a president that is creating the situation and has created a situation in this country where our lives are unsettled, because there are thousands of people in the majority in this country who rely on these elections to make their lives better. Because in the first place, this government did not perform well. This government did not say did not do what they say they will do. And as a result, the no confidence motion came into being as an expression from the people of this country, their frustration, the increased cost of living, and all the ills that we've seen in the short 4 years of this government. At the time of the no confidence motion, people had been fed up. What we have seen in this country in 4 years, by far outmatched in terms of the negative impacts and effects what took place in 23 years of the People's Progressive Party civic government. And so they are refusing to have the cabinet resign. They want to have it open. They can give contracts to their families and friends to make all sorts of deals coming out of those contracts. And we know the ministers and the other officials of the government who are pocketing monies. You will hear a lot more about this corruption ring of the government as we go into the full election season. But I want to say for now that we need to demand the resignation of the government. The business community, their staff, families and friends of each of us must make sure that we lend our voice to what is taking place in this country, to say to the president of this country, we would not have you and your government take us down further. And we are a people that generally respect the rule of law, and we seeing and witnessing a president who says in the first place held the Bible and said that he swear to uphold the Constitution of Guyana, and we have seen so different. Isn't this so reminiscent? Isn't this so familiar? Isn't this exactly what we know the PNC to be? Isn't this what we were warning people about all along, that the PNC could never be trusted? The leopard doesn't change its spot. And let me tell you, we're calling on the international community to intensify the pressure on this government, to have them first of all resign the cabinet, and to have the president adhere to the constitution and name the date for elections within the prescribed time given by the constitution and the ruling of the Caribbean Court of Justice. We are saying that by now, gauging the timelines towards the elections, inclusive of nomination day and training and all the other stuff, that the international community must not wait until the president breach another timeline before they can institute sanctions. They should do it now. They should do it by the time they've measured the out and out date by which the announcement for the date of election should be made, and there is no word forthcoming from the president, the sanctions should immediately step in. Not until after September 18, because this was done in other countries before. And this country, Guyana, must have the support of the international community in instituting these sanctions so that you could bring the president and his government to their senses. There must be sanctions on the country and sanctions on individual. Take away their visas, they must not be able to travel because they have violated our constitution. And this is what we expect. I expect, most of us in this country expect, that we will not have a government that take us for a ride and breach our constitution. I recall in 2014, when the People's Progressive Party civic government was faced with a no confidence motion and the parliament was paroled by President Ramatar, we had a whole gamut of NGOs and civil society organizations making pronouncements. Today, they are nowhere to be heard and to be seen. Not that they've gone out of existence altogether, but just that they refuse to say, to add a word of condemnation to what is taking place today, because it suits their purpose, I suppose. And we know many of those organizations, let me call them Transparency International, SASAD had its say in 2014. You had the Blue Caps, you had the Justice and Peace Commission of the Catholic Church, where are they now? You had the Guyana Association of Women's Lawyers. I haven't heard anything from them. I heard from the Bar Association. The Help and Shelter, it still exists. Where are their voices? Women Across Differences, where are the women voices? The Guyana Human Rights Association, where is the voice of the Human Rights Association? Where is the human rights of the Guyana Public Service Union? And whenever, if ever, Lincoln Lewis speaks, he talks about the GPSU, sorry, that's one. The GTUC, whenever it speaks, it says, oh, we must work together. Oh, the president and the opposition leader has to find a way forward. Nothing close to what it said in 2014. When it condemned in no uncertain terms, the People's Progressive Party said for the prorogation of Parliament, which is a legal provision within the Constitution. Now we have a president that with a government that's fallen, and they're refusing to adhere to the constitutional timeline for elections. In fact, it already passed since March 21st. And again, it would appear as though they want to violate, further violate the ruling of, well, the CCJ. And so this slap on the wrist kind of, you know, statements that they come out with, I would like to see all of these organizations back on track, condemning the government and condemning the dishonest, dishonorable, and untrustworthy President David Granger and his cabal for what they are taking us through in this country. We have to ensure that we stand up for what is right in this country. I want to thank you very much, because I've been keeping track with a small group of persons, of 10 persons, and we've been keeping track of the persons who refuse to register in this house-to-house registration. They've been calling us, we've been making contact with people, and they have indicated to us via email and so forth that they have not registered, they refuse to be registered, and I want to commend them. We have 163,000 persons so far that have refused to register with the present house-to-house exercise, and I commend them. And we need to go to take this number upward and very quickly, and take it beyond the 300,000, so that once we have 300,000-400,000 of us refusing to register, this is the objective, because the registration exercise is unconstitutional and we should not participate in an illegality. My friends, of course, I would like to hear from you via the telephone line. So I will ask you to call the number 226-3310. Please remember to turn the volume of your television set down as you attempt to get through to us here at the studio. Now, while we are waiting the calls, I want to also mention about where we are today in terms of a country that is full of frustration and tensions, has to be solely blamed on President Granger and his government. We seem to have a caller here. Good evening.
Hello, good time.
Yes,
good
evening. Not too bad.
Alright, I watch my program of Slovenic, you don't cry, that is okay?
Yes, I'm hearing you.
What will you have a different man? Don't you have to start from old man, or what am I really different there?
What's your feeling?
Huh?
What's your feeling about what they're on?
You feel that the McCormick has to really chase them out in Hampshire area?
Yes.
Hey, Gianna live.
Right.
Right, but me live on Hayfield, right? Okay, I'll name, right?
Okay.
Family, right? Okay. The government is, right? In the hospital, food, mass, hospital, sorry. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And I will ask something, she signed. Signed for who? She got there for them.
Mm-hmm.
She kissed the gang bad, everything got bad. So what did people ever go?
Mm-hmm.
A hospital, so?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe after all,
So we want to commend you for sticking to the position that we should not register. We
right.
should have. Whenever the ministers and the government officials come, chase them out. The GCOM workers, they are honest, innocent people working for their money, and we shouldn't be confrontational with them. We should just politely say to them that we're not interested in registering. But when the ministers come, you chase them out.
No.
They are illegal, they're making a mockery of our constitution, and the president and others should not be allowed in our communities.
God, you want to have the time come along, right? When he win the election, he be drunk as far as telling who, right?
Well, he's always, as far as I'm concerned.
Right, and me want to go up for town, he will get big power, kill our party, say, we belong, right?
Mm-hmm.
They get rid of Israel, right? course, that kill power thing. What happened to it was now that I get my tax nearly, but I go for my rights now, madam.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you for coming through, caller, and I appreciate your contribution to the program tonight. 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to our viewers. And we seem to have another caller here in the line. Yes, good evening.
Mommy, good night.
Yes, good night, sir.
We are not resistant.
Thank you.
And I want to ask you a question. If the illegal government is still eating our money out in parliament, drinking the Hennessy and got us punishing, I want to know if that's happening still.
Well, there is no parliament, and there cannot be any parliament. The opposition already said that we're not going to parliament. We're not interested in extending their time. There is no business for us to be at parliament, and there should be no business for the government to be in parliament as well. All right? Thank you very much. It's a caretaker government, and they're not required to be in parliament. They're not required to pass any bills. They're not required to do any transactions in parliament or through the parliament. At the moment, they should be preparing for elections, and that should be the only business of this government at this time, because it is a caretaker government, and it is a government on its way out, and so it can get involved in making contracts and so forth, all right, and expending large sums of money except for routine functions, making sure that public servants and so forth are paid and that kind of thing. All right, good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Yes, good evening, man. Not too bad. How are yourself?
Okay, I just want to tell you something, that when you go to the Georgetown House Public Hospital and you have to do tests there, you have to pay $30,000 or sometimes $40,000 to do a test.
Wow.
And it's a public hospital, and why you have to pay at public hospital to do a test?
Well, it just shows how far we have degenerated and how far we have gone in this country. The healthcare system sucks. We have a minister of public health who's talking about lashing people in the head and creating business only for a certain set of people and all sorts of things. No focus on the health center, way out of the league, and we don't even have tablets in the institutions, in the hospitals, in the clinics. Bandage, I'm told. People don't even have drug for the diabetics and all the different conditions that we know that the hospital should have drugs for. And this is, we're just shifting backward and downward, and this is all part of the David Granger bunch, incompetent, corrupt cabal. So
yeah, they are taking us back to Barnaby.
Yeah, we're going sliding backwards so quickly. All right, thank you for coming through. 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to our views across the country. And it is amazing how in 4 years we've slid backwards so quickly. We've slid downward. We've gone backward for the worse, downward for the worse. In 4 years, the government is now just has entered 2 months ago, its fifth year in government. And of course, what we've seen in that time, it's really amazing how quickly a country could degenerate. You know, the thing is, they're coming up with a whole set of new promises. They promised before so many things in 2015, and they never instituted 98% of those promises. They never implemented them. Now they're coming with a whole new promises. Oh, they had bankruptcy. They took over a bankrupt country. Lies, all lies. When they took salaries for themselves and benefits for themselves, and they paid monies to do forensic audits that amount to over $100 million, and they were fancying themselves with the monies from the People's Progressive Party, that the People's Progressive Party civic government left in the treasury, and so many things that they've done wastefully, and they never implemented the promises they claim they will, the things they will do to make people's lives better. That is how dishonest these people are. Now they come up with all sorts of different excuses. Good evening.
Hi, good night, Coy.
Yes, good night.
I thank you very much for what you're doing there.
Okay, thanks.
This government don't care. You are a human being, and you swear to the law of Guyana and the country of Guyana, and you are trying to dethrone them connecting that you swear to who you swear the Bible for, and you say you're God of God. You hold up a Bible and swear that you're a man of God, and why you can't do it?
Yeah.
People want to see it. We need a change in this country because the government is not good anymore.
Yeah.
They're not kept away enough that they can't do nothing for me anymore.
Yeah. All right, thank you for coming through, caller. I do appreciate your contribution to tonight's program. And so the call is so right that people are so tired and disgusted and fed up of this government. People are dying for a change, and we all want the election's date to be named so that we could prepare ourselves to get rid of the government. Many people are fixed in their mind what they have to do. Many people know exactly what they have to do because we've all endured the hardships over the last 4 years of this government, and we've seen all this increase in taxes, and you see that they're so dishonest that they're now trying to copycat the plans and the programs of the People's Progressive Party Civic. Mr. Irfan Ali, our presidential candidate, has been making pronouncements on different measures that he intends to and promises to come into being when he becomes president. And this government is stealing, like, free education. Irfan Ali spoke about that months ago. This government stole that promise from the People's Progressive Party Civic. We've spoken about other issues, about reversing taxes and so forth. They've gone to steal a new set of lies and promises, and we all know where it will take us, but we know that they would have an opportunity to fool us again. Good evening.
Good evening, Kwame.
Yes,
good evening. Why the corrupt opposition scared about the House registration?
Okay, could you hold on for me? I want you to stay on the line. The opposition is not scared of house-to-house registration. The opposition is against house-to-house registration primarily because it will go beyond, it will derail. Why you come off the line? It will derail the timeline for the elections, which the Constitution says 3 months. If you go on with house-to-house registration, it goes way beyond the 3 months for the elections. And so our argument is, why don't you use the existing list with a claims and objection period and have those who are off the list, who would like to come onto the list, make a claim during this period and come onto the list, take all the dead people through the GRO, the process, GCOM knows what the process is, clear up the list of those who have died, and those who need transfers, we can have transfers done during claims and objection. Those who need name change, all of this could be done during the claims and objection exercise. It has been done before, and it can be done. Why would you try to create a new list that will take us close to 2 years to do, and it will derail the timeline for the elections? You see, house-to-house registration may be in normal circumstances. This is a situation where you had a no-confidence motion, the life of the government becomes interrupted, and therefore the need for elections become urgent, and therefore you have to institute all the urgent and necessary means quickly, expeditiously, in a manner that will fulfill the constitutional provision of having the elections in 3 months. So the People's Progressive Party is not scared of anything. We're not scared about anything. We are standing up for the Constitution. We're standing up for the right things. And we all know as well that they, apart from what this house seemed to set out to do, to pad the list with the foreigners and so forth. But that apart, it is not feasible at all to go to house registration now. And I believe that we all know this. Even you who call, I'm sure, understand this argument and reasoning. But some people will pretend that, you know, willful ignorance. And so that's what we seem to have a lot of these days. Good evening.
Hey, good night.
Yes, good night.
Kwame Mc
Coy? It is, yes, ma'am.
I thought if I know something, my father died in 2007. Could I go in GCOM to get his name off?
You don't even need to do that, my dear. You can go that and maybe guide him, but the GRO, registrar's office, they usually send a list of their people for a particular period to GCOM. GCOM then take that list and then take the names of those people off the list. Right? If it still remains in the list during the claims and objection period, you can identify the name and then you can make an objection to the name being on the list. That's how it is done. But this house-to-house exercise is totally unnecessary. It is for all sorts of sinister and diabolic objectives. And we know that the elections ought to be held by September 18th. So there's no way the house-to-house registration will be completed by that time. We are dealing with a time frame and a timeline and a work program by GCOM itself that takes us into mid next year.
Because this thing is worrying me a lot, as I want to go into them to get his name off.
Yes, so it's still on the list. I guess you recognize it on the list still.
Yeah, I think so.
Right, so you should make the effort, but make the effort to have it come off, yes.
I want it off, so I think, you know, you think if I could, should wait.
Well, there's a claims and objection period that will come on, and we're hoping that is very shortly, so that you could use that period to object to the name being on the list, all right?
Okay.
If it's still on the list at that time. All right, 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to the views across the country. The People's Progressive Party Civic is not afraid of anything. Not elections, not house to house, not anything. But we are standing on principle, we are standing on the side of the Constitution, and we are standing on the side of right. Not as we continue to see Granger and his government being dishonest, untrustworthy, undependable, and messing around with our Constitution, violating its provisions, and then making all sorts of excuses. The People's Progressive Party Civic is on the right side of history. Good evening.
Hi, good evening. Bobby?
Yes, it is.
Hi, what happened to the ABC countries and all these bright lions and stuff that we have? Nobody saying anything?
Well, they have had few people. They have people who are speaking out. The ABC has spoken as well. They have spoken, rather. They have made statements to the effect that the government needs to adhere to the Constitution and to do the right thing. But what I hope is that there's an intensification of that pressure and people lending their voices. We need to build the pressure on the government. It's under pressure already. That pressure needs to be intensified. Because, you know, every day David Granger refuses to name the date for elections. Every day, David Granger continues to give us all sorts of flip-flopping. People are more and more turned off from this government. More and more. So, maybe, you know, I hope that they come to their senses and to do so very quickly. Otherwise, they're losing political gains. There's no way they could be ahead of this with all the nonsense that is taking place. No way. So, good evening.
Hello?
Yes, good night.
Hello?
doing, Mike? How are you doing?
Not too bad. How about yourself?
I was good, man. First, I would say that in 2015, when Tara Ramatar announced the election date, that was good. That was really good. And I can't see why the president cannot announce the election date from since December to now.
Yeah.
And it seems to me, we have a president in this country who don't care who come and who leave and who live and who move out and who in this country. Guyana is the only country that those things could happen in. You could go to the United States and do that? No way.
Yeah.
You cannot, no way. You cannot go in no other country and do that. People could come and just move in and bring their bundle and come and live. And you know, come on, Guyana people are getting worse, but the foreigners getting worse.
All right, good. Thank you very much for coming through, Paula. Thanks for your contribution. We continue to take your calls, and I want also to remind you that in 2014, when President Ramatar prorogued the parliament, he did call elections within 3 months of that prorogation. The elections was called within 3 months, right? As prescribed by this constitution. In fact, you could have had a 4 to 3 months prorogation, but he chose to call the elections within the 3 months. So all of this thing, I heard some of the liars on the PNC side saying that the elections is over 9 months and a year before the elections were called in 2015. It's all lies. It doesn't surprise me, actually, because of where it's coming from. All right? So we seem to have another caller here in the line. Yes, good evening.
Good evening, Kwame.
Yes, good evening.
Regular listener to your program.
Thank you.
And I know very concerned citizen of our country is going on. And I'd like to contribute a little.
Okay, go right ahead.
8 months now since there's no constant motion passed. And the president, from all we hear and every day, he has no respect for the Constitution, and he has no way he wants to do anything better than we do it. He wants to punish the nation, and he has the power to do that, and he will do that. He don't want no election. He wants just to have own way. He don't want to give the citizens their rights. Our Democrat, right? He's punishing us too much. Why he can't get together with his party and the government and they do something better? He has nothing. He shows no respect for the Constitution, and I feel he don't want to do anything to go to the election.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. This is a very dangerous president. Absolutely dangerous. And we all know it. Let me tell you something. We know. Look at what is taking place. Look at the signals you have. We're slipping back into a dictatorship. A president, after falling by a no confidence motion, refuses to call the elections in this day and age. In this day and age, 8 months onward, and the elections have not been called. This could only happen with the PNC in Guyana. All right? This could only happen with the PNC in Guyana. So sad. All right. Good evening.
Hey, good night, Bobby.
Yes, good night.
A guy, Carl, only mentioning that. Slap that government pushing up, putting and going away, this thing can happen in America.
That what?
These things that which are doing, what going on in this country can happen.
He was talking about breaching the Constitution in such blatant manner.
Yes.
Yes.
No, I don't want you to quote me. I want you to be honest with me.
No. I
listen to me now, make up my thing. Just allow me. You sit on this television station.
Mm-hmm.
Are you calling President a thief? Are you calling Minister of anyone that they've ever steal from you, and would you have done this? Would you go in and here with the guy in any other country, Kwame? An ordinary old kind of president and even ministers that keep Kwame?
Then let me, you pause. Don't come off. I'm not cutting you off. You stay right on the line. Yes, in other countries I could have done this because there's freedom of expression. I have no fear about speaking what I believe is the situation. Secondly, what you need to understand, if they ever stolen from me, yes, they've stolen from me. I am a taxpayer of this country, and I have monies invested in this country, in the treasury, and therefore, when the minister can't account for the monies, and when the minister, the Durban Park monies, when they can't account for it, then it is my money involved, and then they've stolen from me. The Auditor General can't have those records settled, because they would not give him the information and the monies cannot be accounted for. When we have the situation where the Demerara Harbor Bridge contract was corruptly given to an individual against the laws of this country, the procurement laws, then yes, my money is involved. They have stolen from me. When you could have the minister giving a job, jobs actually, to her company from her ministry, then my money is involved. Yes, they're stealing from me. When you could have a friend of the government, of a tenant, of a minister, the tenant of a minister of a government, who gets a money to buy a building, a house on Sussex Street, and to open a bond, and for our taxpayers' money to be paid, how much, millions of dollars for that bond at a bottom house, then yes, my money is stolen. My money is involved. And so I can go on and on. In 4 short years, this government has racked up over 70 corruption scandals. It is unheard of in the history of this country, even in the 23 years of the People's Progressive Party Civic. And you know what? The thing is, we are in opposition and we are finding the evidence to support our claims. We're not just talking. We sent 5 ministers. We process private criminal charges against them. And the DPP, the Attorney General, said that he influenced the DPP to now process the charges. Those are the matters that we should be familiar with and that concern all of us and that involve the theft of our taxpayer dollars, and it should be concerning to us.
Make one point. About 4 years ago in Trinidad, there was an opposition leader on the other side of the floor, named Mooney Lan. He called a member on the other side a snake. What happened to him?
Mm-hmm.
Trinidad?
Mm-hmm.
They expelled him from parliament. Call another member
mm-hmm.
a snake.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to the nonsense what goes on in this place, he was expelled.
Well,
got to write a witness.
The good thing is I'm not in parliament. I'm here on television and I can talk as freely as I want to within the confines of the law, and I am saying that they have a dishonorable, dishonest, untrustworthy, undependable president. You have a bunch of thieves call themselves the APNU Collective, APNU AFC Collective. You have corruption unabated. You have the Caribbean Report that named this government as the most corrupt in 40 years in the Caribbean, and I can go on. I am happy I'm here. I'm not in parliament. I'm not confined to those rules. I'm here and I will say things as I see it. I've always been a person who's truthful, who's honest with people, and I will continue to do that. I will not allow anyone, you or anyone, to deter me from saying the things that ought to be said to people in this country, because people in this country are tired and fed up of this government. Absolutely so. People want these elections to be held badly because their lives depend on it. We are all going through punishment in this country. Nothing that the government said it will do, they have done. They said they will pay people a 50% increase in salary, 30% and 50%. And guess what they did? They increased their salary by 15% more. Not people's salary. They said that they will do X, Y, Z. I could name it here tonight. But I don't have enough time. And we've seen them done the opposite. We have seen them done the opposite in this country. And that is the problem we have. That's the problem. We have a man, not because you kneel at the altar means you're the most honorable person, or indeed, you know, you have any intention of being honorable, to be for the opposite objective indeed. So that is what we are facing with in this country. And we have an opportunity to stop it now. to stop the president from continually violating our constitution. Good evening.
You know what upsets me? Good night, good night.
Good night.
I'm not a resident of this country. What upsets me, all you guys, EPP, ENP, whatever, all you have done the same thing. Why you guys act like you don't do nothing?
Well, let me correct you there. I beg to differ, and I beg to differ that we are the same thing. Because there are many differentiating features, values, principles between the People's Progressive Party Civic and those of the PNC and the current new administration we see here. By far, you've never had a government minister within the PPP who give contracts to their, take contracts from their ministry and give it to their company, their own company. You've never had a government minister in the PPP who take housing contracts and give it to her husband to build houses. You've never had a PPP on accounting for the stadium or at Durban Park. You've never had a PPP who minister took a contract for 130 something million for the Harbour Bridge and handed to an individual. You've never had a contract where the minister took a pharmaceutical contract and give it to a company, and we all know what is the association, what is the deal behind it, and I can go on and on and on. So there is very much clear differentiating features that do not make us both the same, and I beg to differ. One, the problem is with some people is that you seek to put the plague on both houses. But if your honesty should guide you and your conscience should guide you in the right direction, then you will be honest enough to say and to recognize that we are talking about two different kettle of fish here.
No.
All right? Two different kettle.
I've got a lot of things too. I know. I am not saying
that the PPP is all perfect and we didn't make mistakes, but nothing in comparison to what you've seen under this government. Absolutely nothing in comparison in what you've seen under this APNU AFC government. Absolutely nothing in comparison. So yes, we have made mistakes. We have not been the most perfect, but I could tell you by far we outshine the other side and this government. By far, we are not the same. We are not both at about the same. We are far different. And we are far different. And that is what you need to recognize. That this old gimmick about putting the plague in both houses and to suggest that we both all the same is all about those who want to make excuses for this government and to justify the nonsense and the lawlessness that is taking place in this country. When you can, you should have called here tonight to say the president of this country is violating the constitution. He is wrong. That is the most important topic for this evening, because at the end of the day, the elections are due by September 18. Should have been held since March 21st, 2019. And to come here to suggest, oh, you're all the same, so why you quarrel, and all sorts of nonsense, you will not get away with that, not with Kwame Mc Coy. I'm sorry, you better get it right, and you can call back, because we have a job, and our job as citizens of this country is to make sure that we keep the government accountable to the people. And for now, we know that this government has not been accountable. This government is a rogue, crooked government, and they continue to violate the constitution of this country called Guyana. And we, the people, must stand up against it. Don't call to suggest, oh, you both the same. What does that say about David Granger breaching the constitution? Good evening. Good night. Yes.
These people are there talking about the Mao resigned the other day. PNC Mao resigned. APNU. I can't remember any man in your manner.
Yeah, continue. That's what you want to say? Yeah, whatever.
Because the man said a lot of things about them. They corrupted in there. They're doing a lot of nonsense inside his ear. And the man said that he had to resign because they're not cooperating at all. They're doing all manner of different things.
You're talking name. About the young Dave Danning, yes.
That's his name, yes.
Okay.
He said there's many more other people in here want to come out.
Yes.
To shame.
Yeah. All right, thank you for reminding us about that.
With those people.
Yes. Good. Thank you. 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to our viewers across the country. And we seem to have another caller here on the line. Yes, good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
That's just me, just a call.
Could you turn down your volume and after this continue the call, man? Y'all know the right thing and you still do it all the time.
That's just a call before this caller. Yeah, it's a caller.
If what?
Yeah, it's a caller.
Well, I don't know what condition he's in.
If you are about to start, you said, oh. You are decadent or you are
Yeah, it's this old apologetic approach. Oh, but they all did the same thing. And a lot of times they say that we have to take them up.
Right.
Oh, y'all did the same thing. It's the same boat of y'all. It's the same thing. Lies. Lies. Take them on. Because we never refused to call an elections in this country at the time it should be called. We've never refused that as a government under the People's Progressive Party Civic. We haven't, a lot of the things that happened under this government, we never did it. And even if we dared it, if we dare to do those things, you know, they'll be running helter-skelter in the streets, burning and looting, right? And this threat by Basil Williams, the Attorney General, the threats that he continues to make. I want Basil Williams to know that we're not afraid of his threats because we're not going to let the threats of Basil Williams prevent us from standing up on the side of the Constitution. We're not going to let us prevent us from standing up in the streets and saying, Mr. Granger, you are wrong and that you need to call the elections in. We're not let Basil Williams' threats deter us from any action that we need to carry out in keeping with the confines of the love show, of course. We're not going to let him intimidate us or cause us to retreat. Oh, we should be afraid. Oh, all of these consequences. The people of this country will stand up because this is across political party. This is across race. This is across every difference that we could ever have as a society. This is a fight and a campaign for the president and his cabinet and his government to respect our constitution and to call the elections there. That is what it is about. I'd like to hear we, not y'all. You have to be included. Alright, good, sure. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Good. 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to our viewers across the country. We seem to have another caller here. Yes, good evening.
Hi, good night.
Yes, good night.
I don't know if you are going to a simple advice.
Yes.
I have seen my time, I have seen a lot of things happen with people when they talk, You have to be careful, my brother.
Yeah, I'm always trying to be careful.
To be careful.
Mm-hmm.
These people could be so dovish minded towards you that you, if you don't look sharp tomorrow, you see you get someone super cold or name, you know what I mean?
I don't care.
You have to be careful about that.
Yeah, I hear you and your advice is taken with
careful.
Yes, I hear you and I thank you for that. But let me say, I am careful. I try to be careful. I am within the confines of the law. But that doesn't mean I should be covered. That doesn't mean.
I saw station being closed down for calling names.
Mm.
So you have to be careful.
Well, thank you, but I'm saying that there's nothing that I have done, and I want to bet this, nothing that I have done that is against the law. And you can only come after me if
answer
the station. I agree they could come up and make up all sorts of stuff.
Correct.
But at the end of the day, they have to have some full proof. Because the GNBA, the Broadcasting Authority, is being used at the moment as a agency to censor what is taking place on television with stations they perceive to be supportive of the opposition. And they've been sending all sorts of silly letters around, censoring people's views and all sorts of nonsense. But let me say this, that at the end of the day, I come here well prepared. I give the facts, I give perspectives. They do not infringe on the law. They are part of my freedom of expression, and let them challenge me. Let them come after me.
I know you're a good person.
Let them come after me.
But I just want you to just to be careful.
Thank you very much, and I do appreciate that. Thank you very much. 226-3310 is the number to call. Let's continue to listen to our viewers across the country. And we, I'll probably just be able to take one more call. The red light is on me, and I will have to just narrow this to one other caller. Good evening.
Hey, good night, Kwame.
Yes, good night.
How are you doing?
Not too bad. How are yourself?
I'm good. I always watch your program, but you take my number,
Well, you know, the truth is that I'm not doubting that might have been the case. The honest truth is that there's so many people to return calls, and sometimes it may have slipped me or the number got mixed up. I'm sorry. But I make a note here. I will endeavor to have a call
to
you.
I want to hold on to call because Guyana News on CGTN this morning is not $4 billion. $4 trillion is Guyana economic power.
Mm-hmm.
The crew that they banking on the world market. So, okay. There is a reason why the people do not want to lose power.
This is supposed to be a democracy. No matter what they think and what they want to hold on to, you have to have elections. Anyway, thank you for coming through. I thank you very much for a good night. And of course, the callers who came through very lively. And I want to say to you that we have a situation in this country that all of us need to keep the pressure up on the government. They have to come to grips with the constitutional provisions. They have to call the elections within the constitutional time frame, and they must adhere to the constitution. The cabinet must resign, and calling on the international community, the NGOs, all civil society, individuals, we need to lend our voices to this. Because, you know, this is beyond the PPP. This is beyond, when I say beyond, this is not about the PPP. This is not about an individual. This is for our country. This is the best we can do for our country. Have our government adhere to the constitution and the rule of law. And I thank you once again for tuning in on tonight's program. Do join me next Monday for another edition of Square Talk. In the meantime, God bless you.